research that from the Economist Intelligence Unit on the democracy falling from the previous years till the 2017. And then here, just I want to sum up some important issues of that. The democracy index is based on five categories. I mean, electoral process and pluralism, civil liberties, the functioning of government, political participation, political culture. Those categories were chosen by the researchers. So think about that. That's some kind of metrics that they use to measure democracy. Okay? And so, based on its scores on a range of indicators within these categories, each country is then classified as one of four types of regime: full democracy, flawed democracy, hybrid regime, and authoritarian regime. So you see that they looked for 165 independent states, and then that was the final result. Full democracy is 19, flow of democracy is 57, hybrid regime is 39, and authoritarian regime 52, according to their classification. So, and if you want more, if you like more detail, okay, this is a summary that somebody else already talked this morning, and then this is just a graphical representation of that. So the first ones are Norway, Iceland, Sweden, New Zealand, Denmark, the first five, and then you see United States is 21. But the most interesting thing is that those ones are real democracies, but and according to this classification, United States is a flawed democracy, you know, see, yeah. Just ahead of Italy and Japan, okay? And then going down, you find Portugal, France, Estonia, Israel, Belgium, Taiwan, and so forth.
Where were we in 2016?
Well, you go to, you know, to the web, you find all the data you like. And so, we got a decline in media freedom and curbs of freedom and speech are only one aspect of a broad-based deterioration of the practice of democracy in recent years. We have been going through a democracy recession. But, and according to this study, the main manifestation of this democracy recession include declining popular participation in election politics. This is tremendously true in the United States, where, you know, the final result is just decided by, I think, 37% of population only. And then weakness in the functioning of government, declining trust in institutions, dwindling the appeal of mainstream and representative parties, growing influence of unelected and unaccountable institutions and expert bodies, widening gap between political elites and electorates, decline in media freedoms, erosion of civil liberties, including curbs of free speech. Okay, this is according to this research, obviously. And a matter of fact is that our society is an arbitrary, complex, multi-scale system of systems of purposes, actors, and agents with continuous change. This is my assumption, and is the assumption that I used for writing my paper that was distributed today. And I like to have your feedback on that. If you find time, just to have a look at that. Present planetary problems are the legacy of multi-scale order deficiencies from the past obsolete Western human reductionist worldview. They cannot be fixed by the usual traditional hierarchical approach alone, by doing what we do better or more intensely, but rather by changing the way we do, the way we understand the meaning of information. Of information in the sense of the meaning that we have to be in relation with other people, okay? Not just information in the computer's meaning. If we are going to manage the fourth industrial revolution with the same discriminatory blindness and focus of denial with which we managed the previous industrial revolutions, the negative effect will be exponential. Zucconi. Okay? At social level, inequality and unemployment destroy opportunity freedom. Radical inequality significantly undermines opportunity freedoms and capacity freedoms and consequently radically undermines human capital and as a foundation of community prosperity. Nagan. As the global age seems to bring new possibilities and challenges, we need now to think in much broader terms than even before. This is, we talk about illusions, I present just the latest one. In real democracy, whatever it may mean, holistic governance requires the co-production of values between policymakers and citizens to make visible political and expert guidance and people interests and concerns. Transparency of communication between citizens and policymakers is far more than making information available. It is building up effective co-organizational systems. And here I am referring to the effort that United Kingdom. And specifically, in 2020, Britain will be able to monitor in real time the decision, the effect of the decision made by single counties all over their territory. In real time. Yes?
Why do you make a distinction between citizens and policymakers? Don't answer the question, I just put it.
I know, we can talk about, many hours on that, but it's just to synthesize things. Okay, but for me, the important result is that we have to look at something that United Kingdom already did, and they are close to the final result to get a digital democracy in the good sense, not in the best sense. Yes, because if in the future, if we want to manage things in the right way, speed is everything. Yes, speed of acquiring information that you need. In that sense, the faster you get the kind of information, the more ready you will be to answer questions in a reliable way. And that is the reason in Italy, some past governments just didn't invest in the information infrastructure, in the networking structure of Italy. Just the reverse position that UK did. Okay? This is interesting. So we get more technical here, but... We don't like technical details, but just to give you an idea, from a cybernetic point of view, we just use this the second level for our system, and so we need to go to the third and to the fourth level to be aware of our reality. This is a matter of education. We need this kind of diagram to educate young people, just to know the different way you can manage information, the different way you can use information to get your system a real-time system. This new awareness can guide any quantum leap to more convenient future post-human cybernetic approaches, social science and technology, because the latest discovery for social science is that some researchers that just discovered that the behavior of social science can be immediately simulated by quantum physics and vice versa. Isn't that amazing? And so, a few questions are just the three questions that you found on the presentation of this session. But then you see the first one, I try to put the categories that I got from the economy study, just to give you an idea. But then, what are the most common weaknesses, failures associated with democratic form of governance? I think that we already saw a lot of examples from today. And then what are the underlying problems or sources of these failing defectors that limit and prevent addressing them effectively? But then I think that we need a few more questions. Are we ready for that? Okay. And without forgetting that, the realized work is always in progress. Yes. Thank you for your attention.